Hello, everybody. We are trying this again, so hopefully it works. Let us know if you can hear us. We basically wanted to talk about how we are navigating the whole being at home together, and the things that we're doing. I'm pretty sure everybody has their own things that they're doing. So give us a thumbs up if you are here and if you can see us and everything like that to make sure that, you know, the sound works this time. Okay, welcome to Corona Conversations. I just made that up yesterday. And I have the Sid. She's my special guest. So if you're here, everybody say what's up to the Sid. Hey, Sid.
Hi.
So what we're gonna do is we're gonna talk about how we've been navigating the last few days. She's been home, out of school. Now, I've worked at home from home for 9 years, so I'm used to this. This is just what I do. I'm used to doing it. Hey, Chili Fee. So we are doing this together here at this point. So, Sid.
Yes.
What have you been doing? Well, first of all, what did you think when they said school was out, and what did you think was going to happen?
Well, I thought that we were going to have spring break just straight off the bat, like,
right,
we can go out.
Right.
But no. Well, yes and no. Okay. It just, like, depends on, like, where you're going. Because, like, we can be out here, but, like, you can't be, like, in an enclosed space. Like, I can't go to the mall or, like, Dave and Buster's. I mean,
right. And so how did you feel about that? That you could not go and you knew you couldn't go. How did you feel about that?
Very upset.
And like, why were you so upset? Because if they're telling you you're staying in because you're being safe, why were you upset?
Because everybody else was going out. And because for like my age group, it's a 97.5% chance of me getting it. And like my immune system is okay to like the point where I won't get it. I get sick maybe once a year, even if that.
Okay.
So I was just feeling like, I know I'm not going to get sick. Like, this isn't even, like, what is it called?
Hey, T. Sheila.
What is it called? Like, projected towards my age group.
Okay.
So, like, if it was, like, projected towards my age group and I knew that, like, it could affect me, then I would feel differently about it. But I know, so since I know that, like, it's not affecting me and it's not even about, like, my age group, I feel like I still should be able to, like, go out.
Okay, so now, where are you getting your information from? Because...
I'm getting my information from...
hey, Dr. King.
What is...
Where are you getting your information from?
Why did I tell you yesterday? I forgot. Oh, BuzzFeedNews.com.
Okay. So, listen, everybody. We all know we all have multi-generational houses at this point, right? So, we have elementary school kids. So you have those children who need to be guided and need to be doing something every second of the day. They're used to a lot of structure. So you have to figure out age-appropriate things for them. Then we have teens who are in high school, and there's age-appropriate stuff for them to be doing, and we're going to talk about that. And then you have the collegiates who unfortunately have had to come home. So they are feeling some kind of emotions about having to come home. Their parents are feeling some kind of emotion about coming home. I've gotten a lot of things talk about my child is eating me out of house and home. They don't want to follow the rules because they're used to being on their own. So you really just have to figure out what makes sense for your family. And what happens in another family is not going to work maybe in your family. So if you agree with that, give me a thumbs up, give me a heart. And if you have any suggestions, specifically the educators, Dr. King is on from Fairfax County. Any of you other teachers or educators, if you have something, hey, Troy, if you have something, then share. Because at this point, we're all in this together and we all need the same information, and then we can modify when it makes sense for us. So, since the Sid has been home, what have you been doing?
Okay, I dyed my hair purple. That's one thing I did.
Uh-huh.
I cleaned my room, even though I wasn't going to say that, because I know y'all going to make y'all kids clean y'all house. It's okay, though. I wasn't trying to throw y'all out there like that, but it's okay. It's okay. I cleaned my room. I dyed my hair. I've been on the phone with my friends watching, because a lot of new seasons on Netflix came out. So I've been watching Love is Blind. All American is another one that I'm watching. And
what else have you been doing?
SAT.
Is mandatory every single day?
SAT, SOL, and my review.
Right. So
And take my vitamins.
Driving.
Driving.
SAT and SOL. She's on Khan Academy and any other little thing that helps to make sure that she's trying to stay on top of everything, because, you know, the brain needs a routine. And Dr. King is saying the students need a routine because they can get dressed every day or stressed every day. I can't see. Chores are a good one. And it's so hilarious because since it was like, I ain't really trying to tell parents to have their kids clean, because then she didn't want to set up the kids who parents might not have done it. But our house is pretty much spick and span right now because she had time. We talk about sweeping, mopping, dusting, everything.
Vacuuming.
So those are the things that we've been doing. Now, the other day, probably on Friday or Saturday, we had an incident where she wanted to go out with her friends, or she wanted her friends to come to my home. Yeah. Now, in the beginning, I was like, okay. But then as I started to hear other people really get serious about this, I decided that she wasn't going to be able to come over. The little girl wasn't going to be able to come over. And then
she was already on her way.
Well, she was already on her way. Oh, well. But I made an executive decision. And then the Sid, hey, Abby, hey, Visa. The Sid got a little upset and was starting to have like a little meltdown. And I was like, pull it together. Okay? So this is the thing that I really want to share with everybody. You as parents, as grandparents, as aunties and uncles or whatever, we are all going through this together. And we have no idea about what is happening. So I don't have the answer. Grandma does not have the answer. Hey Maria, love you too, Abby. We don't have these answers. We are all trying to figure this out at the same time. We are all going day by day. So I didn't want to have to choke her. I just wanted her to understand that I'm trying to figure it out too. We're outside on the balcony because I love being outside. I want to be outside. Of course, I want to go hang with my friends. Of course, I want to go work and do things. You know, I have postponed, I'm saying, hey, Cousin George, 7 of my major events for my book have been canceled just in the last week. That was one, that was my money. And number two, those were going to be amazing experiences for me to have. And did I want to be sitting in the house and to have those postponed and maybe even canceled? Absolutely not. So we're all going through this. We're all trying to figure it out. And so the best thing for you to do as a suggestion is to talk to your children and make sure that you understand what they're feeling. You know, Sydney, tell them how you were feeling and how you've been feeling over the last few days. And you can tell them the truth.
To be honest, I cried multiple times in my room, like all day, from Thursday till like yesterday. Today I haven't cried. We'll see though.
Crying for what?
Because I feel so stressed out. Like I know that I'm not gonna get it, and I know that it's like gonna help me staying in the house, but I feel like so enclosed because I'm barely home. Like I'm barely ever home.
Yeah.
Unless like something like is going on where I have to stay home. But like I like being home. I don't really like being out. But now that I have to stay home,
right,
I want to be out.
Right.
It's like I don't want to not have the choice to not being able to
go out.
Hey,
friend. Hey, Tom. So it's a psychological situation that we're in now. So that's what you have to do. You have to keep your mind, your body, and your spirit straight. Because, and that looks different for everybody. And Chili Fee, that's my girl from home, from TF, she's saying that her daughter Farron is having meltdowns. Yeah. I'm pretty sure that a lot of people are. But yesterday we got out, And we will be going out to a park.
I can't even take a walk. I asked to take a walk.
But we will be going out to a park in a day or so. It just depends, okay. Depending on the sun.
And it seems to be calming down, like the whole virus talk from what I've seen personally. It seems to be calming down. Like, they're not, like, after yesterday, it was, like, after they gave everybody their curfew, like, in New Jersey, where, like, my cousin lives, they have an 8 o'clock curfew. So, like, they can't come out the house past 8 o'clock. And in Maryland, they can't come out the house past 5. Or, like, I think this everything shuts down at 5.
Right.
So, I feel like after that, it's been, like, kind of, like, dying down to the point where, like, maybe Friday I can go out. Or maybe, like, Saturday, like, or into next week I can do something with my friends, have them over. So, yeah.
So what we will do is we will just see what happens. And that's for all of you. We're all taking this day by day. And so we will just see what happens. So the things that you can be doing, control the things that you can control. We can't control all these different things that are happening. You have an amazing opportunity to do some more research so that you can figure out for yourself, what do you feel about what is happening? I have my own thoughts about it. I'm not getting vaccinated. I don't care what they say.
Yeah, I'm not getting vaccinated.
And I know it was man-made because there's no reason for an animal disease to be able to hop over to a human unless it was man-made. So I digress. I'm not even going to get into my theories. But what we're going to do in here is we're going to continue to love each other. I exercised this morning. Sydney did something amazing today.
What did
you just now do? For the first time ever. She filed her taxes.
So we are mommy's classroom in here.
So she has her schoolwork and she does whatever, but I also do real life stuff. So it's been mommy's classroom since she was a baby. She's 17 now. So she wants to be an event planner. She wants to do hair and she also likes kids. So, I'm an event planner, 25 years experience. I have a business. We're going to sit here and we're going to do all these budgets that I never got a chance to follow back on from my book tour. If any of you were following me, you saw me in LA, you saw me in Atlanta, you saw me in Richmond, and you saw me around DC with my book. Well, those things all cost money. So, we're going to sit down and do the budget. So, I'm calling it Mommy's Classroom. So whatever practical things that you can do for your children, hey Karma, whatever you can do that's practical for your children to teach them real life skills, because we are all learning a real life skill right now, and that's called survival. The human body is going to fight to survive at every point. So that's what she's watching. And I'm also being honest with her, and I'm telling her that I don't have the answers. I don't know when we're going out, but we are going out. So you also have to provide hope. The other thing is when you're eating a lot of carbs and eating a lot of sugar, that affects the brain, that affects the mental. So you also have to make sure that you're giving your family good food, because just pigging out on things that are not good for you is not going to help them stay mentally sharp. Because you don't know if they're going to say get in your car and roll either. You don't know that. So you don't want to be sluggish. You want to be prepared. You want to have worked out. You want to be energetic. And you want to be ready for whatever the move is going to be. So we're going to end here. We appreciate you all.
Did you just call?
Dr. King said, did I just call? Yeah, because something's in my throat. Let me drink a little water. Any last tips or any last thoughts from you, Sid? Miss Carmen says she need to get that hair color. Sid. So that's really what I wanted to share. Everything is age appropriate for your elementaries, for your teens, and for your collegiates who are all home and don't really want to be home. And definitely send a prayer and a shout out to the seniors of colleges and high schools, because they're not able to graduate on time. I see that they just canceled Howard's graduation the other day. Sydney's friends who are seniors, they don't have a clear view of what's
and
going to happen moving forward.
Too.
And they canceled classes?
Like
Dr. King like is on, so don't be making up nothing.
I'm not. some of my teachers, they're like not even giving us work. They're like, just have a good break. Like, just relax. Okay. But like, I don't know if that's gonna be like for the whole time, but for like right now, they're just saying like, get some rest until we know what's going on. And they're telling us we don't even know, like they don't even know what's going on, but they're like keeping us posted in like our Google Classrooms and whatever else, like our Blackboards, whatever else.
Right.
And everybody uses.
And Karma is saying that there's no prom, so it's all going to get
better. Our prom
better.
Didn't get canceled.
This is the thing, we have to give each other hope.
She said they will.
There's a James Cleveland song that is called, it's a gospel song by artist James Cleveland, and it is called This Too Shall Pass. This Too Shall Pass. You can hear it on anywhere that they hear music, YouTube, whatever. This too will pass, everybody, as long as we do our part and control what we can control. We can control our diet, we can control what we consume from the media and from food and the chit chat that we're talking. If we're talking to our friends and our family and they're talking negative, don't talk to them. Keep your vibes high. Keep your vibration high. I watched this awesome show on Netflix yesterday called Gentified. It's about a Mexican family in LA who was trying to not be gentrified. Their taco stand be gentrified in LA. I was snickering. I was laughing out loud. I'm so emotionally invested in the characters. I was crying. It was just an amazing show. So find something that makes you feel good. So we'll end it there. We thank you so much for listening. And we got some more Mommy's Classroom to go. We're going to eat some lunch. And then we're going to eventually get to this Harry Potter movie show. Number 5.
Yeah.
So have a good day, everybody. Please share this. Please say anything that you would like to say on here. Ask any questions. Maybe the family will, somebody will come up and have an answer for you. There's some great suggestions in here from the educators. And then Walt gonna say stop bullying. She had her say. She got to say. Any last words?
No.
Okay, so she has no last words. We thank you. Share it. Share it. Share it. We're just sharing the information so that everybody
can
navigate
Tuesday.
This. So that everybody can make through this, and we will survive. This too shall pass. Peace.